The Federal Capital Territory FCT High Court has sentenced Maryam Sanda to death by hanging for killing her husband, Bilyaminu Bello. Justice Yusuf Halilu gave the sentence on Monday in Abuja while delivering judgment on the protracted trial of Missus Sanda. He sentenced Sanda after she was convicted for stabbing late Bilyaminu to death, son of former National Chairman of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, Halilu Bello. Upon a conviction by the judge, Sanda broke down in tears and wept uncontrollably. Following the judge's sentence, she was whisked away from the court by NSC officials who were accompanied by security operatives and made wailing friends and family members of Sanda. And joining us to break down this analysis of domestic violence this morning is life coach Steph Redd. Thank you, Steph, for joining us on News on Hour.
Thank you, Benny.
Let's consider the issue of domestic violence, how prevalent and how underreported it is in Nigeria.
I think a lot of times it's quite high. And I think one of the issues is the thing of a lot of times when you come forward with it, this thing of, oh, protect your marriage or don't talk about it. Oh, it's husband and wife matter, leave it that way. Of which it goes both ways. There's domestic violence from male to female and from female to male. But it's not spoken about enough. It's only those, a lot of times it gets to the extreme before we talk about it.
Maybe we should start off this way. I should have asked us, what is domestic violence? For those who might not know, what constitutes as domestic violence?
Okay, domestic violence is anything that makes the other person either feel unsafe, particularly when it comes to battery. And sometimes, so it could be verbal. It could be verbal abuse, it could be mental abuse, but the worst case of it is physical abuse, yes. So in a nutshell, pretty much that's what domestic violence is all about, where you have to raise something or raise your hands or use something against your partner or the other person, yes, that causes the person harm up until death.
Now, let's come away from already married folks, people who are maybe in some kind of courtship relationship right now. Are there signs, are there red flags, are there warning signs that you could see to let you know you probably might be dealing with a partner who could be that violent domestically at home? What are the signs? What are the red flags to watch out for?
So I believe red flags to watch out for pretty much starts from the partner's inability to control self, to manage emotions and to manage their those moments of anger, where there either has to be voices raised or to the point of physical attack. Even people in relationships experience that. We've heard a lot of stories of that where they're dating and then he gets angry and he hits her, or she gets angry and she pushes him, all of that, right? Those are signs that you want to say, okay, this could get worse. Because once you're getting, other things could trigger. Marriage comes with its own complications. And you want to add those complications to signs that you already saw. You want to start avoiding that early enough, yeah. So when you see such things as someone raises his voice, someone's unable to control his temper, someone's unable to, already hits you or pushes you or shoves you or, shakes you up, yes. So those are signs you want to be careful.
Unfortunately for Bilyaminu, he's not here to tell his own side of a story, because he was stabbed multiple times to his death. Now, let's talk about, we have a culture and tradition here where, it's being there till death do you part, and you're constantly living with an abusive partner. Before it gets to it being physical, there are other things that come up, like you rightly mentioned, there's the emotional, there's the mental, there's the verbal abuse. Where do partners begin to draw the line with a physically abusive partner? So you know what, I think it's time I exit.
Yeah.
Because our culture promotes, stay there till you die.
So, okay, I believe that there, when you're already in, so it's a different thing if you're in a relationship and then you can quickly exit. But when you're in, one of the things I advise is you need to come back to the table to define the rules of engagement, right?
Yeah.
So it's probably okay. It's a moment of, you want to excuse that it's a moment of, okay, I'm not able to control myself and I just give you a gbasgbos, right? And then like, okay.
But it starts from there.
It starts from there. Yeah. It starts from that gbasgbos.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then like, okay, I love you. Let us see how we can work this out. But the rules of engagement have to change. You can't hit me. You can't do this. You can't do that. So let us agree on what is acceptable, which a lot of times should have been done before you get into the commitment. However, at that point, you want to begin to redefine lines. And sometimes the gbasgbos may be too intense. Depending on the intensity, you may want to separate and get counseling, or separate to redefine your coming together. Right. So I believe it's something that at that point, people, women, men should think of the future of a potential worst case scenario and redefine the moment or exit as soon as possible.
Now, in this case, it was a case of she alleging that he was cheating on her. Is that a deal breaker? And what could lead, and people who are in the relationship right now and there's a bit, little bit of violence going on, what could be prevented for it not to get to this point? Because I only believe Bilyaminu must have had signs to say, you know what, my life is under threat. And now this is a man here. The most cases we know are men battering their wives. But this is a wife killing the husband.
Okay, so in the light of that, really, it's because you would have thought, you know, one, you want to think of like, okay, the man has physical strength, more, probably height and all of that. So how did he get to the point where she overpowered him and was able to do that? But in all of that, I think it's now the point of to say, okay, there's rage in everybody. For you to get to that point where a situation gets you so angry that you pick up something and cause bodily harm up until the point of death to someone else, that's an extreme level of rage. And it just comes to how well do we know how we can manage our emotions at that point? How well are we able to pause? Now, you say, okay, it was because she found out that he was cheating on her. Now, what could have she would have considered extreme is what someone would just be like, oh, okay, and pass over. So what did that person think about, or what did that person consider to determine, okay, I am not going to go this extreme, I'm going to use this measure, I'm probably going to just walk away, I'm probably going to just, you know, let us end it, right? But so it's now a thing, what was her state of mind? And we all need to check it. What is our state of mind? What is the state of our mental health and our emotional health, such that we are able to manage ourselves effectively in the heat of such instances where it's like as though our emotions take over us? So at that point, I believe that she pretty much could have consider the situation, I mean, consider the outcome. There's something we talked about earlier about thinking about the outcome of doing something before doing it. So if she had thought about the possible effects of what she would do, she probably would have taken different decisions. Probably would not have done that. She probably would have counted the cost and decided on the right action to take as against just going this way. And then, hey.
All right, your final thoughts this morning. What would you advise people watching and they're having cases of domestic violence in their home as it's obtainable right now? What's your word of advice to them? As a life coach, either in marriage, a relationship, what would be your advice at this point?
Domestic violence is terrible. It causes mental stress. It causes psychological stress. It causes all sorts of stress to the person. And it affects you. It affects your output. It affects your everything, your thought
process. Your esteem, your self-worth.
It affects your self-esteem, your self-worth, your self-value. So it has to be nipped in the bud. The moment you see that there is domestic violence, begin to take action to stop it or to exit from it. Get help, get counsel, get a refresher and redefine every relationship. The coming together of two people is to become better simply because they feel, oh, I can do better with another. But when being together with someone makes you feel less than yourself, makes you feel insecure, makes you feel incompetent simply because you're with someone, then it is a sick, you can say that is a sick togetherness. There should be healing. There should be warmth. So when you are when you're in such a state, seek help. When you're in such a state, exit to review again and redefine the reason for that union before you get set. Decide whether you want to go further with it or whether you want to end it, but make sure that whatever decision you make is in the best interest of you and the best interest of those around you.
Life coach, Steph Redd, thank you very much for joining us on News on the Hour.
Thank you.